Hey everyone, bloodmako here, and this is my video for the latest event, Ferris's Raid. So this is the Shinryu fight. So you're fighting two of these, I think they're called Crystal Amour. And right off the bat, if you guys are doing it, like, you know, blind, you'll notice that you'll be only doing once, like what you see Tifa do right here. Like, okay, you can't really see because of the numbers, but yeah, she's actually only doing one brief damage. But because she has so much battery, then yeah, that's why she actually, you know, is still able to do damage. It's just that she can't break them. So then you see me actually use Call right here, his LD, and his what do you call it? The unique HP attack after that. Yeah, there we go, to break them, because you do rainbow damage, rainbow numbers with Call. So yeah, that's the reason why I use his LD, and then you see him doing once again. So the reason why I'm doing once is because these bosses, they actually have, you actually have to hit them with water, I believe. I think a few of the old JP videos, he just brought Garnet and then use her base call, so you don't even need her LD, just her base call will do. And yeah, after that your team should be constantly hitting, it might not be a max damage, max brief damage, but you'll definitely be doing more than one. Another interesting thing is that if you guys will notice later on, at least, these bosses, they actually cut in order. So every single time you take or your party does a move, be it call or an instant skill, they will actually immediately take a turn. I believe this was the normal one, like the normal you know, turn order. They have not done anything special yet. And yeah, so I decided to bring Luna Freya in and just build the FR up. I sped this up so that you know, you don't have to see through all this. But basically my goal is to actually just bring, you know, get the FR gauge going. So, since I already brought, technically I brought three characters that has FR, but I actually was thinking whether I should FR with Tifa or with Call. And for this fight, I opted to go with Call because of how often the enemy goes, and because of Kane being able to also increase the FR gauge. You know, the bonus, the damage bonus at least. So yeah, so I opted to go with Call, but Tifa works as well. It's just that the in terms of the turn order, it would have been better for me to FR with Call, because in terms of the bonus at least. So right here, I think the bosses still have not gotten their unique buff that lets them cut in order. I think it should be around when Kane goes into the air. And it is a buff, I believe, and it's not the HP threshold. That's what I think at least, because of right here I was actually thinking, should I use Kate Sif's Call at this point of time, but I believe it was a little bit too early, so yeah, that's the reason why I didn't use it. Yeah, anyway, as I was saying, I believe that it is tied to the buff and not related to the HP threshold, but I could be wrong. In fact, we'll see it really soon actually, because I'm actually going to FR with Call really soon, if I'm not wrong. So as you can see, everybody is doing more than one at least, so yeah. And I believe that is that the, no, that's not, that's attack up, either attack up strength or strength up and brief damage up, I believe. I'm not sure though. So right here again, I was thinking, should I by doing that, I will definitely charge the gauge up, you know, I'll definitely be 100% and Tifa can straight go into her FR, but I'm not set up properly for her because I don't have a burst up yet. The timing for Tifa is a bit tricky because of how short her burst is. It's actually only 8 turns, I believe, and her FR is not an instant, you know, instant move like people like Tidus and Kane. So you actually have to plan it better. So right here was when I was actually considering who I should use the FR with, be it Tifa or Call. So yes, I believe that is the unique debuff. The one where okay, again, I'm not sure which one of the buffs is it, but you saw that it said additional turn triggered, and I believe that was the buff or the indicator that the boss will constantly be taking turns after your party member does anything. So you can see the bosses actually went again after after I did Kate Sif's call. And also another thing is that they cannot be broken, I believe, out of this additional turn. So let's say Call does his follow up his preemptive move, and Kane does his in fact Kane won't, so just calls a preemptive move. I don't think you are able to break the additional turn at least. So right here I decided to use Call's FR, and I believe that was a pretty decent a move to make because of how often the bosses will take turns. So every time the boss takes turns, right, you will also increase the FR gauge by 5%. And again, you might think that it's not a lot, but considering the fact that they are about to take 4 turns, 2 right now, and another 2 additional time with when Tifa takes a turn, and if I time it correctly, they will take another 2 additional turns after I use an instant skill with Tifa, so that's about 30%, you know, not including the damage that Call and Kane will be doing, you know, after they take turns and before they take turns. So you know, I think in terms of the damage, I believe this is the right move. Yeah. So opted to use the Syrinx Call. If I had managed to get a selfie friend, I would have swapped Reigns for someone like Luna Freya, and then I'll probably FR with Tifa, you know. As you can see, I'm not sure why Syrinx is only doing 1. I'm not sure if it's because the debuff from Garnet wore off, but again, I'm not sure why the rest are able to do numbers, you know, like decent damage. I'm not sure why. I know that the water enchant is still up, but I believe it is only a self water enchant. So yeah, I'm not really sure about the mechanics as to why I'm able to do damage with some and not the rest. So the reason why I right here at least, the reason why I did not use Battlecry twice is because of the Syrinx Call. There's only 2 turns on it, and if I had used both, then I will not be able to launch inside the BT phase. So yeah, so I only use 1. So I went into the BT phase at 4th gauge turn, 8 remaining. Yeah. In fact, considering the fact that of how much damage I'm doing, I actually could have went into the BT phase a lot earlier. Like immediately after the series call, I could have just went in. Yeah, it wouldn't have wouldn't have mattered at least, because if you guys fast forward towards the end, you actually see that the last boss that I'm killing was actually an overkill. In fact, it was multiple overkills. So I believe that even without that battle cry after the Syrinx Call, I would have still been able to kill both the bosses. So honestly, if you reach this part of the fight, you're more or less set, you know. They have 60-ish, 70% health. Yeah, and Tifa just gonna melt them down. Yeah, it's really a joke how much damage you can do. And I believe that you should always prioritize launching over the perfect setup for Tifa, you know, the Luna Freya, and then, you know, taking the 3 turns. Yeah. I feel like the launch actually takes a priority because of how much damage difference the launch does compared to when you use the Luna Freya comp. Because I believe this one I did like I think it was like 145 million as compared to the previous video where I did lesser than 100. So yeah, you know, I believe that's where all the different launches you know, that's the difference is basically just the launches. So if I had the selfie call, then yes, it makes sense to use the Luna Freya call. If I had a selfie friend, then it makes sense to use the Luna Freya call. But since I didn't manage to get a selfie friend, then yeah, I have to make do, right? So I think I'm just gonna end the commentary right here. The boss actually dies within this burst phase, so yeah. And oh yes, and the recast move that the boss does, he does not gain any brave before or after he does it. So if he's broken, there's a very good chance that you will not take any damage. So you don't have to worry about the HP threshold in terms of that, in terms of, you know, taking damage from the boss. If you want to be on the safer side, you can just run the same as me. I ran the brothers, and then I was ready to just go into summon just so that I will not take any damage. So yeah guys, I think this is it. I'm just gonna end the commentary right here. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. ここからが本番。ふっと覚悟できた。限界を超える。お、やるからには勝たなきゃね。